So hi all, welcome to our YouTube channel. So we are back again with the most important questions for Prelim 2020, and the word of the day is perseverance. All right, so moving on to the very first question. Consider the following statements. Virtual currency is the overall superset that includes digital currency, which in turn includes cryptocurrency. Second statement, virtual currency can be regulated or unregulated, but digital currency often remains unregulated. Third statement, cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin and Ethereum are considered to be a part of the virtual currency group. Select the correct code, A, 1 and 2 only, B, 3 only, C, 2 only, D, none. So here the correct answer is, you can pause the video and mention your answers in the comment section below. It's B, 3 only. Okay? Now the reason being is that your digital currency is actually the overall superset, which in turn includes your virtual currency and then again includes your cryptocurrency. Okay? So that is why yahan pe ye statement incorrect ho jata hai pehla wala. Ab aate, what exactly is your digital currency? So basically it is an electronic form of currency, alright, which helps in instant transaction across the world. And hamara jo virtual currency hai, wo ek subset hai hamare digital currency ka, alright. And ab second statement kyun galat hai? Because virtual currency is always unregulated, alright. And hamara jo digital currency hai, it can be both regulated or unregulated, alright. Therefore, ye statement 2 incorrect ho jata hai. And before we move on, let me just tell you quickly, cryptocurrency is nothing but your virtual currency, alright, which is a very secured form of transaction by cryptography. Okay, this is based on your blockchain technology. And blockchain hota kya hai? Blockchain is your digital ledger which contains all the transaction, and it is a very secured form of technology, and it can, this data which is stored in your blockchain cannot be modified, alright. So moving on to the next question. Now, which of the following statements here are correct? First, a merger requires two companies to consolidate into a new entity with a new ownership and management structure. Second statement, in an acquisition, smaller company is often consumed and ceases to exist with its asset becoming a part of the larger company. Third statement, Narasimham committee recommended consolidation through a process of merging strong banks. Fourth statement, the Competition Commission of India allowed for an automatic system for speedy approval for certain categories of merger and acquisition. Select the correct code, A, all of the above, B, none of the above, C, 3 and 4 only, D, 1 only. So now, yahan pe the correct answer is A, all of the above, alright. Achha, to abhi ye news mein kyun hai? It is because the Competition Commission recently introduced this new concept called Green Channel, alright, which will allow for speedy approval for certain combination of subject, alright. But one must know it is subject to certain terms and conditions, theek hai? So recently ye approval hame kiya tha in terms of merger and acquisition. Now, moving on to the next question. Now, which of the following statements here are incorrect? Now, please note it says incorrect, alright? First statement. Geostationary orbit satellite follows the Earth's rotation by travelling at exactly the same rate as the Earth. Second statement. The low Earth orbit satellite must always orbit along Earth's equator. Third statement. Sun-synchronous orbit satellites are all synchronized to always be in the same fixed position relative to the Sun. Now select the correct code, A, 1 and 3 only, B, 2 only, C, 3 only, D, none. So now the incorrect statement here is B, 2 only. Okay? Now, chalo hum dekhte from the start, what is all these orbits? Okay? First, we must understand that, then we'll come back to the question. Now, please excuse my drawing here, okay. Ye aapka earth ho gaya, theek hai. I'll take a different color. Now, in terms of your geostationary orbit hai na, this will always be over your earth's equator, theek hai. And the satellite which is parked here will revolve in the same direction as the earth move, that is west to east. Okay? And this is one of the reasons why most of our satellite antennas which are on earth, it is placed in such a way that it gets this connection permanently from the geostationary satellite, and therefore we do not have to rotate or rotate these antennas, and they are always pointed permanently in the sky in a very fixed position, since because the geostationary satellite itself is fixed in this one position in the orbit. ठीक है, now अभी geosynchronous क्या होता है? ठीक है, now your geosynchronous is basically, yeah, so this is your earth. ठीक है, the situation, I'll take a different color again. Now your geosynchronous is not same as your geostationary. ठीक है, आप just understand, this is just for your understanding purpose that I'm doing this. Now this orbit is at any inclination. ठीक है, this it does not always stay at the equator. ठीक है, and this जो satellite geosynchronous पे होता है ना, it will rotate at the same time as the earth. ठीक है, now your earth basically takes 23 hours 56 minutes and 4 seconds to rotate. ठीक है, so your satellite which is in the geosynchronous orbit will take the exact amount of time. ठीक है, and therefore this is actually the key difference between geostationary and geosynchronous. ठीक है, कि geostationary हमेशा earth पे रहता है and geosynchronous is at any inclination. So for example, if you are standing, okay, at one position and if you are looking at the sky here, तो अगर तुम geostationary को देखोगे ना, तो it will be in the same place, the same one place throughout the day. Anytime you see, the satellite will always be there. कौन सा वाला? Geostationary. But if you are looking at a geosynchronous satellite, ठीक है, in the sky, and if you are standing here, तो एक particular time पे और एक particular place pe you will see this satellite for every day of your life. All right, so this is one of the key difference between the two. Now the question here was, theek hai, ki geostationary orbit follows the earth rotation by traveling exactly at the same rate as the earth, which is true. This is also the case for geosynchronous also. So basically hamara jo geostationary orbit hai, it's like a special case for geosynchronous orbit. All right, और यहाँ पे दिया गया था कि लो अर्थ ऑर्बिट सैटेलाइट मस्ट ऑलवेज ऑर्बिट अलोंग अर्थ्स इक्वेटर. अब ये गलत क्यों था? सो नाउ द रीजन बीइंग इज दैट द लो अर्थ ऑर्बिट एज अ नेम सजेस्ट इज वेरी क्लोज टू द अर्थ सर्फेस. ठीक है, लाइक ऑलमोस्ट एट एन एल्टीट्यूड ऑफ 1000 किलोमीटर, एंड इट डज नॉट ऑलवेज हैव टू फॉलो द अर्थ्स पाथ अराउंड, ओके, Earth's path around the same way, because their plane can always be tilted, because ठीक है, the plane is always tilted, but in case of geostationary अगर हम देखते हैं तो it is always along the equator. ठीक है, तो ये एक difference हो जाता है दोनों में. अब आते हैं third चीज की तरफ कि what is sun synchronous. Now in order to understand sun synchronous, so you must understand first what is polar synchronous. ठीक है, ये आपका earth है, something of this. Now, in terms of your polar synchronous, now this orbit is like this. Okay, satellites जो polar synchronous में होते हैं, वो हमेशा north to south जाते हैं. ठीक है, so this is also a key difference in terms of geostationary geosynchronous, के जो वो वाले होते हैं satellites, वो हमेशा east to west जाते हैं. But अगर हम ये देखें, तो ये north to south जाते हैं polar synchronous वाले. ठीक है, and excuse me, so the polar orbit travels north to south over the poles, and also it takes about half an hour for the full rotation. Therefore they are used for basically monitoring crops and like in terms of global security, the forest and all of that. All right, so abhi polar synchronous ka ek special case hai jise hum kehte hain sun synchronous orbit. Theek hai, which passes over the earth at any given point at the same local solar time. ठीक है, now this will always remain in earth's shadow, therefore it is also called dusk to dawn satellite. ठीक है, because it will never go into the night time, है ना, तो ये एक difference हो गया हमारे यहाँ पे. So I hope you got this, so I'll just repeat it for your purpose. Geostationary orbit satellite follows the Earth rotation by traveling exactly the same rate as the Earth? Correct. Low Earth orbit satellite must always orbit along Earth's equator? No, this is incorrect. Okay. Why incorrect? Because they can be tilted to any particular inclination. Sun synchronous orbit satellites are synchronized to always be in the same fixed position relative to the sun. Correct. Okay. Moving on to the next question. Which of the following terms have been defined in the Indian Constitution? First, office of profits. Second, constitutional morality. Third, violation of constitution. Fourth, minorities. Fifth, Anglo-Indian. Choose the correct code. A, 1 only. B, 1, 2, 3, 4 only. C, 1, 2, 3 only. D, 5 only. Okay, now the correct answer here is D, 5 only. So, hamare constitution mein sirf Anglo-Indian define kiya gaya hai. Baki ye jo concept hai na, from 1 to 4 have not been defined in our constitution. So, moving on to the fifth question. Now, first statement, Press Council of India is a statutory quasi-judicial authority. Second, the Press Council is headed by a chairman who has by convention been a retired judge of the Supreme Court of India. Third, it does not have the power to review the functioning of electronic media like radio, television and internet media. So, the correct answer here is A, all of the above, alright. And a little fact is that the Press Council of India only overviews the functioning of press media, alright. And thus it can enforce standards upon newspaper, journals and other forms of print media. Print media, yaad rakhna ye. Now, moving on to the next question. Sansad Adarsh Gram Yojana has been initiated by which of the following ministry? First, Ministry of Rural Development. Second, Ministry of Home Affairs. Third, Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. Fourth, Ministry of Finance. Now, the correct answer here is first, Ministry of Rural Development. Okay, ab ye hai kya Adarsh Gram Yojana? It is basically in which every member of parliament will take up the responsibility of developing physical and institutional infrastructure in three of the villages by 2019. This was supposed to be the goal. And they will make basically Adarsh village or model villages. Now, which of the following statements here are correct? First, the main constituent of indelible ink is silver nitrate, which reacts with the skin protein and makes a strong bond. Second, Mysore paint, which was founded by Maharaja Krishna Nagaraja. Third statement, Wadiyar Fort is a sole supplier and producer of indelible ink for civic body. Select the correct code. A, 1 only. B, none. C, both. D, 2 only. Now, here the correct answer is A, 1 only. Okay. Now, the reason being is that this ink is developed by the Council for Scientific and Industrial Research, okay? And Mysore paint is only the sole supplier and not the producer. So, just note that. Moving on to the next question. India has become the first country in the world to issue biometric seafarer identity document to its seafarer. Second statement, the project has been implemented under the merchant shipping rules. A, none. B, both. C, 1 only. D, 2 only. So, the correct answer here is B, both. Okay? And a little fact is that this project is undertaken by the Ministry of Shipping in collaboration with the Center for Development of Advanced Computing. So, please dhyan rakhna ye. Moving on to the next question. Choose the correct statement with reference to real effective exchange rate. First statement, RER is a weighted average of country's currency in relation to an index or basket of other major currencies. For example, jaise dollar le lo US ka, theek hai? Pound le lo hamare Europe ka. Now, second, if the RER is less than 100, then the domestic currency is undervalued. Third, the indices of RER in India are released by Ministry of Finance. So, correct statement kya hai yahan pe? A, 1, 2, 3, B, 2 and 3 only, C, none, D, 1 only. So, here the right answer is ए ऑल ऑफ द अबव, ऑलराइट। एंड एक छोटा चीज याद रखना, इफ द रेयर इज मोर देन 100 देन द डोमेस्टिक करेंसी ऑफ द कंट्री इज ओवर वैल्यूड, ठीक है। नाउ द वेरी लास्ट, चूज द करेक्टली मैच पेयर्स। फर्स्ट स्टेटमेंट ऑपरेशन वेनिला मैडागास्कर, सेकेंड ऑपरेशन इंसानियत बांग्लादेश, थर्ड ऑपरेशन सहयोग केरला, फोर्थ ऑपरेशन ट्रांस पंजाब। सेलेक्ट द करेक्ट कोड, ए 1, 2, 3, बी नन, सी 1 ओनली, डी 2 ओनली। सो नाउ योर करेक्ट आंसर योर इज ए 1, 2, 3। क्यू ऑपरेशन ट्रांस गलत है, इट इज नॉट इन पंजाब, ठीक है। नाउ ऑपरेशन ट्रांस है क्या, उससे पहले हम विल जस्ट सी व्हाट आर द अदर। सो बेसिकली ऑपरेशन वेनिला इज बाय द इंडियन आर्मी which is launched to rescue people which were hit by flood in Kerala, and they actually built a 40 kilometer Operation Vanilla is actually to assist the population of the Madagascar people which were affected by Cyclone Diana, ठीक है। And Operation Insaniyat is by our army to assist the humanitarian crisis which was there in Bangladesh, and they basically brought relief packages to the Rohingya Muslims which were stuck there, ठीक है। And Operation Sahyog is actually to help the people which were hit by floods in Kerala, alright. And there they built a 40 kilometer long bridge, alright. Now Operation Trans kya hai and why is that statement incorrect? So it was by the Narcotics Control Bureau of India which in order to curb the menace of these psychotropic drugs and other sedatives and painkillers that were being used without prescriptions. So it is by that, it is not in particular state as such, theek hai. And it was remember that it was by the Narcotics Control Bureau of India. Now that's it for the day, and for more information on our various courses, please visit our website www.aishas.com, and like, share and subscribe to our YouTube channel. All right, thank you.